September 30th, 2014, approximately 6:45 p.m. And that's the sunset, western sky. Now, according to the compass I have, west is straight just to the right of that tree. Okay, but the sun is setting slightly southwest. I guess the season, perhaps, the earth being off its axis slightly when there was that earthquake in 2011, or that tsunami, or whenever, because they've been having a lot of catastrophic type earthquakes and tsunami and Fukushima and all that stuff. Of course, none of that is man-god made, for sure. You know, that's just nature. But that's the sunset. You have clouds. And I'm sorry to be so suspicious, but my gut tells me I'm right, and I am right probably about 95 or more percent of the time. But some of that is chemtrail that's come down for the way it's made. From experience of seeing chemtrails in the past, that's chemtrail that's come down from the high altitude. It spreads out like it does as it comes down. There may be some cloud mix in with it back there. That's probably majority of that would probably be, I would say, probably 80% clouds and 20% chemtrail. This is chemtrail mix. Just chemtrail right here all spread out. You can see that line right there. Let me get a point right up there. There should be a line. I can't see on this viewfinder. Chemtrail right above that tree. Right there. Just the smokiness. It's been foggy too a lot this year. Every single morning I wake up, and it's not unusual to have dew on the grass and everything. But this last 3 weeks, 2 weeks at least, it's been like a thick fog every day. And my wife says, well, it was like that last year. No, it wasn't. We may have had a couple days where it was foggy a little bit, but this has been every single day. Wake up in the morning, and you can't not see that trailer over there. They don't look like they have a security light on over there either. I just noticed that. Well, there's usually a security light over there by that pole. Surely their electricity's on. I don't even want to think about that right now. But the fog is so thick, you cannot see those trees back there at all. So some people want to believe it's not as bad as it actually is. That helps them cope, I guess. But no, it's a pretty sunset. I got this tilled up here. Just right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pepper plants here. They're still putting out some peppers on them. That's why they're in the ground still. See that big bell pepper right there, and the fourth one back has got a big couple of big bell peppers on it. I'm kind of like saving those for very last. All that is tilled up. I started to go over there back where that onion plant is, and I'm tilling that just little by little in with it. I cut off 5 or 6 okras this morning, pods. And tomorrow there might be 2 or 3 more to be cut off. On a daily basis, basically cut off anywhere from 2 to 8 okra pods. See, look at this one already. This was not this big this morning. I would have cut this one off. Look at that. I don't have my knife on me, or do I? Oh, that's a rarity. I don't have it on me. But this one here, that one will be a little bit longer tomorrow, perhaps. Maybe long enough to cut off. And another one right back here. This one, I saw this. See, the growth on this one wasn't all the way up. Usually it comes completely off your tape and you'll cut it off. But see, I might let that grow another day. Maybe even tomorrow evening cut it off if it grows that fast. But at one time there were 14 okra plants put out here. Nothing grew back here. I didn't understand that. Just these 7 right here. But with the rains and the flooding out here, we hacked the heck out of this garden up. So that's why it's really uneven now. And nothing else was gonna grow. So that beetle. Next year, the okra is gonna be over that way, and so is are the tomatoes and the peppers on the other eastern side of the garden. They're gonna be running north to south like these are now. And they grew fairly good until we messed them up by trying to irrigate the garden. Ended up flooding it on the plants and gave them root rot by holding too much water all the time. But again, it's one of those live and learn. Look at the leaves on this one, how it's turning. Yeah, these black-eyed peas here, today is Tuesday, Friday. Well, actually, Thursday night into Friday it's going to rain, so maybe Thursday evening I'll come out here and pick. See, there's still quite a few. Look at this one. Totally green. You know, it's really green. Like, it just came out. It's producing strong. Look at this one here. Now, there's a lot of green bean pods out here. I don't want to pick them too soon. I mean, I'm trying to just pick these ones as they dry out. See, this is yellow. But another day or two, it'll be dry enough to pick off the vine here. You can see a lot of green ones here still. We've got about 5 pounds of black-eyed peas out here from 8 plants. And that's all been within the last 2 weeks. 5 pounds of black-eyed peas. So, again, it's going to be something a little bit different. It's going to be plastic out here, too. And supposedly, I'm supposed to still get my plastic to cover this. It was 40 by 40. Now I've gone about another foot and a half. So it's going to be probably around 42 by 42 when it's all said and done. Okay, watermelon and squash, zucchini will be in the back there. Like I said, I might even go off to the right there, a little east. This will all be tilled up, all this. Like I say, sunflowers, I forgot I have sunflowers. I'm going to put that as a front row. I'm going to put a bunch of them too. I'm going to throw down like 50 of them or so around the edge here to get them to grow up. This is the only shade in the morning. Around 10 o'clock in the summer, especially after 10 o'clock or so, the sun is already up over these here, and you'll get full sun. Everything out here will be full sun. It's sun about 95%, 96% of the time. Just in the morning until about 10, 11 o'clock, you have shade up until about half of this part of the field right here. And there's that thing up there. So. Anyway, you think he knew something? Look, a lightning bug. I don't know if I can get him on camera here. Oh, he's flying up there. There he goes. There are lightning bugs out here still, so. Okay, that's all. I just wanted to show you the sky a little bit and a little bit about the garden out here. So, I hope y'all are growing you a couple tomato plants, pepper plants, maybe a bean plant. You know, I'm gonna have to do something.